Greetings, yo. Lovely day, right? Greetings, goddesses and gods. I'm walking to the truck looking crazy today. Excuse my poor video crafting, because I really don't give a fuck anyway. It's just about a message anyway, right? It's not about being perfect or imperfect. Or I mean, it's about being imperfect. It's about being imperfect. Imperfect is where it is. Imperfect. Yeah, because it's not perfect. Nothing is perfect. They want you to believe that everything is perfect. They want you to believe that you gotta do this. They want you to believe that there's this way, that there's a way, when there really is no way, but the way is inside. Beautiful goddesses and gods of creation. Copyright. Copyright. Fuckers. I'm picking my nose. Alright, so let me get down to it. These are some symptoms. Whoa! Hey, yo! These are some symptoms. Say that word. Symptoms. It's like empowering, right? It's an empowering word. Or should I say symbol? Symbol. How do you know you're in the fifth dimension? How do you know? You just do. You know why? Because nothing is perfect, okay? There is no dark. There is no light. It's only thought. Thought. What kind of thought do you have? Where is your attention going? Are you a conspiracy? Let's just say conspiracy. Are you paying attention to conspiracy? Because I tell you what, that's not the fifth dimension. You're not in the fifth dimension. If I gotta tell people that you gotta wake up and there's all these bad things going on and there's someone in the sky watching every moment I say, not me. That's not me. That's I don't believe in those things. They exist. They may have existed in other people's worlds, not in my world. This is how I do magic, because I don't believe in it. It doesn't exist. And then when you believe it doesn't exist, when you believe that it's not there, it's not. It becomes nothing. Then now where do you go? You got to go inside, right? And this is where people become scared, because what they find out there is just only inside of you. Yeah, these things go on. Okay, it does, but that's not what awake. That's not being awake. That's being under control, right? When you say, "Oh my God, there's this going on," and you know, people are getting kidnapped. You know, all right, well, let's show compassion and get away from it. That's all you can do. You can't do anything about someone being anywhere, because they already are. They're already on it. They know. They listen to you. They know what's going on. Let them deal with it. Let the world deal with it. That's not your world. Your world is your heart. Your world is your soul. Not a conspiracy. That's not conspiracy one bit. Conspiracy is meant to keep you in the third dimension. When you go into the fifth dimension, this new age term is a term for mental illness or schizophrenia or psychosis or neurotic or whatever fucking term you want to use, right? Because there's a dragonfly right in front of me. He's telling me to just be my fucking self. And what is myself? Crazy. Myself is crazy, because you know why? Because when people start handing me these weird games, you know, like the game of Catholic school, that game, that was a game to me, right? So I started to question the rules of this game. They didn't like that. No, ho, ho. You don't question. So they gave me another game. Go see a psychiatrist. And then I started questioning the psychiatrist. They don't even know what's wrong. They can't even put a word. They don't have a word for what I am. Imagine that. A doctor, someone who was trained, not educated, trained. Education is experience, memory. That's your education. They were trained to call it these different terms. Because why do they call it different terms? So they can create more consumerism. So they can create more customers. But again, that's third dimensional talk, and I don't go there anymore. Now I've went through all that. I've discovered now these are places I've been. Now what the fifth dimension is about is shining your heart. Where is your heart? What is your soul? What exactly are we talking about? Memory, intuit, knowing. The same knowing that colonialism is trying to rape from you. Because they know the power of the fifth dimension, the imagination, as you will, or whatever term you want to use. These symbols or terms that don't, we got, again, these symbols, here's another one. Here's another way you find out you're in the fifth dimension is the word delusion does not exist. The word delusion is a gift. The word hallucinate is a gift. Why is it that when you're on acid or DMT or mushrooms, why do you hallucinate? Why is that hallucination so bad from a natural hallucination? Explain that to me. What's the difference? Why? Because, okay, so the one that's harmed, the one that's in self-harm himself, he cannot pull themselves out of this delusion. They don't have the will to go in and out. Why? Because they were socially conditioned, right? Through school, institutions, schooling, parenting, bloodlines, all want to keep you trapped because they don't want you thinking outside of the way you were raised. That's not how we raised you. Why? Why am I being raised the way you want me to be? That's not question. Why? So instead, we'll steal your soul by you know, when you're a child. You know, it's fucking fucks you up. It fucks you up. And here's another way that you know you're in the fifth dimension is when you lose all your cult. You could be your mother, your father. You no longer contact with them. Anything, because you know. And when they start questioning, when they start saying stuff like, "Ah, you're so happy. You look good. You're happy," but you know, again, they're not happy. That makes them angry. Like, how does he pull himself out of it? It's okay. It's okay. Like I said, it's okay to live in the matrix. The problem is when you believe those are the only rules to go by. When you believe those are the only rules to go by, you get hurt. Because when those rules fail, you have nowhere else to go. Where are you going to go? What are you going to? Because you don't believe in nothing else but the matrix. Wake up, clock in, go to work, take a shit, brush my teeth, do this, look a certain way for this, make this person more money, make this person rich, buy this person a new vacation home, buy this person this, help this doctor out because I'm mentally fucked up, so I'm going to help the doctor out and help him get out of his rut when they're not even fucking helping you. How is that, like for real, man? Let's think about all that. Just think about it. There's no waking up. We're already are woke. It's just now that we have to go through this fucked upness to remember what it is that we're here to do. To remember that this is all a game. The game of the third dimensional game. It's all it is. It's a game on language. It's a game on the higher realms. Think of what a fucking psychic does. Go talk to a psychic and tell me that they're not delusional. Tell me that. Tell me they're not delusional. But yet they're writing books. They're being creative. Here's the word creative. They're being creative because they're expressing what's outside of this fucking illusion. This fucking matrix that everyone's in. They're expressing the awareness outside of this crap. How can they do that? Because they're in the present moment, looking at all the observation. They're not looking, they're observing all of the signs and the omens all around them. Because that's going to tell them where they're going to end up. I don't know how else to explain that. But These are just ways you know that you're in the fifth dimension. When these conspiracies are no longer your reality, you just say, you know, I've been following the same conspiracies for 42 years. Listening to my grandparents talk about the same conspiracies for 60 years of their life. And, you know, it's just on and on. It's the same. Keep you in here. Keep you down. Keep you here. Yes, it's going on. But what are you going to do about it? Go be Batman and go out and fucking control everything and wipe it away? No, that's what they want. That's what they want you to do, because now you seem crazy. Now that's crazy. They're going to lock you up, put you in a room, give you medication, because that ain't right. You dig? Like, so what you have to do is be creative and speak what you cannot say. How do you speak what you cannot say? You write poetry, drama, entertain. Entertain people. Art, advanced reality transformation. Be a painter. There's no such thing as a Picasso. That's the garbage. What's real is in your heart. That's real. That's the only real thing here is your heart. That's the soul of the world. The language of the world is in your heart. Not about a conspiracy. And there's no conspiracy in your heart, but your heart. So again, memories and experiences. And I'm not talking about this lifetime. Once you understand that why do you get memories of certain gods? Think about this. Why do you get memories of certain gods and goddesses? And why do these names stick out to you? Why are they like stuck to you like a rubber band? Because that's part of you. That is you. That's where your knowledge, that's where you've been. You dig? And where have you been somewhere now is your degree for teaching. So I've been through this Greek age. I've been through the Roman era. I've been through World War II. I've been these places. Why are there stories? Because we're attracted to certain stories is going to tell us where we've been. You dig? Certain TV there, or anything, any of these memories, that's all it is. And once you can, you know, once we learn how to communicate this type of language, Now we're just artists. We're like the comedian who just thinks it's funny. You dig? Like, or we're the filmmaker who wants to make a movie and show you how fucked up his mind.